This video, we're going to tackle about the topic from dynamics of rigid body, specifically the relative motion in terms of velocity. For example, number one, we have that the wheel of radius R is equals to 300 mm, rolls to the right without slipping, and has the velocity of 3 meters per second of its center O. Calculate the velocity of the points A on the wheel for the instant represented. Let's see. Kasi mali, sikat lang yun. So, stated the problem, we have to calculate the velocity of the point A on the wheel. So, in the figure below, we have the given of point A and point O. Para makuha natin yung velocity at point A, we have to use the formula of velocity of point A is equals to initial velocity plus the velocity of A of O. As you can see from the formula, we have the velocity of point A is equals to initial velocity plus the velocity of A of O. So, as you can see, we have two missing terms. So, dito sa A, velocity of A of O, makukuha natin siya or equal din siya sa velocity of A of O is equals to the radius multiplied by the theta prime. Yung theta prime nga pala natin is not equal to the theta given here. So, theta prime here is equals to also in angular velocity. Angular velocity is equals to the initial velocity over the radius. So simply, angular velocity is equals to the initial velocity, which is 3 meters per second, all over the radius. Convert natin sa meters. So equals to 0.3 meters. So we have the angular velocity of 10 radian per second. Since nakuha na natin yung angular velocity, mag-proceed na tayo sa pagkuha ng velocity of A of O. So, same formula here. We have B sub A of O is equals to the radius O multiplied by the theta prime. Which is theta prime is also equals to the angular velocity. So, simply, velocity of A of O is equals to the radius of point O, which is 200, multiply, convert natin sa meters, 0.2 meters, multiply by the theta prime, which is given as angular velocity, multiply by the 10 radian per second. So simply, makukuha natin is equals to 2 meters per second. Since we have the value of B of A of O, we have to determine the velocity of point A. So simply, we have to assume a free body diagram at point A, which is equals to the vertical one, which is the velocity of point A. The horizontal is the velocity or the initial velocity. And then this, the slant one is the velocity of point A of O. So using the law of cosine, we assume these three velocity as point A, point B, and point C. Simply, formula, velocity of point A is equals to the velocity or the initial velocity squared. Correction, it is squared. Plus, the velocity of A of O squared minus 2 multiplying the initial velocity. Multiply again the velocity of A of O, cosine 60. So, nagtataka kayo kung bakit cosine 60. Since yung theta natin is, theta is equals to 30 degrees. Since we have the rotation here, na-doubly po yung kanyang degrees o yung theta. So, evaluating the formula given, we have the initial velocity squared So simply, we have the value of initial velocity, which is 3 squared plus the velocity of A of O is equal to negative 2 squared minus 2 multiplied by the initial velocity 3 multiplied by negative 2 cosine 60 degrees. Kung nagtataka kayo, bakit negative yung nakasulat dito? Since we have the here the velocity of A of O is equal to 2 meters per second. So, ang nakadahilanan niyan, yung angular velocity natin is magiging negative due to the paper rule. So, that means yung ating magiging sagot dito sa velocity of A of O is magiging negative din. So, simply, velocity of point A is equals to 19 square root para makancel yung squared square root. So V of A is equals to 4.36 meters per second.